Members of the community, friends, and family, good afternoon and welcome to the 2015 Beatrice Crawford Memorial Concert. On behalf of the MSU Chorale, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the Tri-State premiere and the 15th performance of Alzheimer's Stories. This work embraces the history, personal stories, and experiences of loved ones touched by Alzheimer's disease. I am here today to share my Alzheimer's story. My name is Emily Schladebeck, and I am a sophomore in the Vocal Music Education Program. When I was informed that we were performing this piece, I knew it was going to be a bit difficult for me, for my father suffered with early onset Alzheimer's disease. When I was 12 years old, my father was moved out of his home and checked into an assisted living facility. Sometimes I would visit him, and my older brother and sister would accompany me along with my aunt. I distinctly remember how difficult these visits were because almost all of my father's memory was gone. There is one visit that stands out from the rest, and I will remember it for as long as I live. My aunt took my siblings and me to visit my dad for his birthday. While we were celebrating with birthday cake, I remember him being very agitated and asking a series of questions out of confusion. Questions like, "Why are we eating cake?" or "Whose birthday is it?" And the most painful question of all, "Who are you people?" I remember how hard it was hearing my dad say things like that. The three of us did our best to be strong and hold back our tears. We did this so we wouldn't get our dad upset, because we knew if he saw us crying, then he would as well. So we just stayed silent and stared into our laps. My aunt explained to my dad that we were his family. She would say, "Phil, these are your kids. Jessica, Christopher, and Emily." Once he realized that it was his sister and his kids who he could no longer recognize, he began to cry. Seeing my dad, a proud military officer, break into tears before me is an image I can never forget. In order to calm my dad down, my aunt suggested to us that we share what we had going on in our lives as a distraction for him. My older sister Jessica said, "Dad, I'm in Oliver Twist. I'm in the dancing ensemble." Immediately, my dad stopped crying. He looked up and started to sing and conduct the overture to Oliver Twist. It was truly remarkable because we thought his memory was completely gone. But at that moment, we had hope. We knew that parts of my dad were still in there. Unfortunately, that was the last time that I saw my father, for he died about 1 year later. It was the hardest time of my life because I was a 13-year-old girl and my dad was gone. I have learned a lot since my father's death. First and foremost, I know that my dad's suffering is over and he is at peace. I also know that he loves me and my siblings more than anything else. Even though he couldn't remember us, he knew that we were important. I have also learned that good can come from a bad situation. For example, my sweet 16 birthday party was a fundraiser for Alzheimer's disease. I had asked my friends and family to wear purple, the color of Alzheimer's awareness, to my party. And in lieu of any gifts, I asked them to donate money to the Alzheimer's Association. The result of my sweet 16 party was $5,000 raised and donated to the Alzheimer's Association to further their research. I am thankful for Robert Cohen and Herschel Garfein, who wrote this beautiful piece, because it will help raise awareness about this disease in a very unique way. Alzheimer's Stories is an intelligent score with very accurate text, and I definitely felt a strong connection with my dad during our rehearsals. I am proud to dedicate our performance to his memory, along with the names of the other loved ones from within our community. I am also thankful for Dr. Buchanan, Stephen Ryan, Michael Allworth, Nicole Jodois, and all of the other student leaders who have worked so hard to make this concert a success. I am particularly thankful for the 165 singers of the MSU Chorale standing behind me, along with our brilliant soloists, Adriana Zabala and Keith Phares, and our wonderful chamber orchestra. The chorale has been working very hard this semester to perfect this piece, and it is a special honor to collaborate with professional artists for this performance. Lastly, I would like to thank Dr. Cole, our honored guests, my family, and all of you for being here today. I hope this concert inspires you to help put an end to this disease. There is nothing worse than seeing someone that you love, someone with so much character and so much knowledge, literally disappear before your eyes and know that there is nothing anyone can do to stop it. I want to live in a world where no one else has to suffer the way that my dad did. This is my story. I sincerely hope you enjoy our performance this afternoon. Thank you.
Oh. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.